Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's look at using Memoji on a Mac in Big Sur. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So up until now, you've only been able to use Memoji and Animoji on iOS or iPad OS. But in macOS Big Sur, you can now create them and use them at least in one way on your Mac. So you'll find them in the Messages app. When you're composing a new message, you've got a button here to the left now. You can click that and get to things like photos, animated GIFs, the message special effects. They're all now gathered here. And you have Memoji stickers. When you choose Memoji stickers, you'll see the Memoji that you've created. Also, Animoji, which are these special characters that Apple has created. iPhone has synced the ones you've created on your iPhone here, so you have those. But you can also create new ones here. So let's start with just looking at how to create them. Click the button here and you get the option to edit the one you have currently selected, duplicate it so you can edit a copy, delete it, or create a new one from scratch. Let's create a new one from scratch. And you can see here the entire interface for creating Memoji has been brought over to the Mac. So to create one, what you basically do is you go through all the categories here on the left and then select various attributes here on the right. So let's start with skin. I can select a skin color. I can choose something natural, or I could go with whatever color I want. It's really up to you whether or not you create something that looks like you, or a version of you, or maybe just a character that you're going to use. Now with every color here, you could drag back and forth to change the tone. So you really have a lot of colors to choose from. Then you could scroll down in any one of these and choose different things. Like for instance, under skin, you can choose freckles. You can alter the cheeks a bit and set a color for kind of a little highlight on the cheeks. You can add a beauty spot. Now we'll go to hairstyle. Now a lot of these will have to load in when you get to them. So we'll wait here for these to load. And you have hairstyles. You can scroll through these. So I'll go and I'll choose something that kind of looks like me. I'll choose that hairstyle there. At the top of this, you've got color. When you see this here, you can click and reveal more colors. So I could choose something like this and then maybe make it darker. Maybe something like this would actually be a little bit better. And then it can continue on to browse. Play with the color if I want. And you always scroll down to find more things. For instance, I can find a forehead mark here, brow piercings, under eyes. Let's go with something a little deeper set. I've got eye color here. Then you could play with the eyelashes, add eyeliner, eyeshadow. Under head, here you've got age. So I'll age myself a little bit here. And then I could also play with the shape. Now let's go to nose. And you could pick one of these. You could also add things like nose piercings. Pick a style, pick a color. Go to mouth. And choose one that you like. Also teeth. And here we see something that doesn't quite make sense here on Mac, because if we were doing this on the iPhone, the camera would be used to actually mimic our expression here. So as I'm building this, I can move my eyes around, move my head around, open my mouth, and the character would react to what I'm doing. So if I wanted to see what my teeth look like, I could select one of these and actually just open my mouth to see them. But here you really can't. So you kind of got to guess. You could also go with mouth piercings, tongue piercings. And you could go through here with different types of ears, add some earrings as well, and then also even add AirPods. And you could just do it mixing and matching, so audio left and audio right. So I could put AirPods in only one ear if I like. So you can add sideburns, and you could add mustache and beard here. So let's go and add something close to what I've actually got. Like that. And there's a lot of different ones to choose from. Then you could add eyewear. and there are glasses and also an eye patch that you could add. And then finally Headwear. Now this is where I should point out that it's pretty easy to edit these. We saw the edit button before. So you may want to have a character like this and maybe at a particular time put a different hat on and then change your hat for another occasion because it's easy just to turn it off. A lot of options to show style, occupation, etc. You also can choose a face covering to choose from one of two kinds of masks. And I like that you can choose really all these different colors. So for instance, if I wanted to, you know, pick the color of my favorite sports team, I could do that. And just like hats, this is easy to change. So once you've finished, you can click Done. And now this will appear in the list here. So you can see I've got these two. So you can have several different characters. So if you want, you could duplicate it and have one with a baseball cap and one without, and then switch between them really easily. Now, how do you use these once you've created them? Well, there are a lot of different ways. For instance, use them on the iPhone. For instance, you could use them while FaceTiming on the iPhone. But the only way that you could use them here on a Mac is as a sticker. So these are the stickers here. And basically, they're like emoji, but they're using your character instead of just a default round face or something. So you can use it to express emotion. A lot of different emotions here. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Lots of hand gestures, things like that. Just a whole collection of various different things that you could use. Now on the iPhone you can use these same stickers, but there's also functionality there to have the camera track your face and you can make your own expression and send that. And of course you can also record yourself talking using this character and it will animate along with what you say and how you move your head during the animation. But here on the Mac, at least for now, you just have these stickers. So let me go ahead and add one here like this. And you can see it appears here. Now it actually appears as a graphic. So even if somebody on the other end has an older version of Mac OS or a non-Apple device, they'll still get this as an image. And keep in mind you can still use any of the Animoji characters here as well. So for instance, if you wanted to use the monkey here and have, you know, the monkey give a wink or something like that, you know, you can go ahead and use one of those. You get that in addition to your own Memoji characters. So while this is only just a tiny bit of the functionality that you actually get on iOS, at least we now have the ability to send the most basic kind of Memojis, these Memoji stickers, on our Mac in the Messages app. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.